Dr. Divyansh.
Can I have the presentation, please? Okay. So, good evening, respected judges, and good evening, my dear friends. Today, my topic of presentation is comparison of a standard OCT versus an innovative wide field OCT. So, what does an innovation mean for us? So, I thank all my contributors and my mentor, Dr. Mahesh, for that. This is the first case to make you understand what it is. As we can see, this is a clear-cut case where a surgery may be required, but these all are flat proliferations when I see with an indirect ophthalmoscope. So I had ordered for an OCT. What I would see on an OCT, as you can see, the dissection plane is somewhere over the macula or the fovea, and there is a traction over the macula and the fovea. I needed to understand, is there any other plane otherwise? This is the other part of the scan. As you can see, nasally till the point it is extending, I'm not able to see any plane of dissection. Whether there is inferiorly it is tightly adherent and it is plastered over the retina. Where should I start in this case? This is the second case, as you can see. In this case, it's a case of a PDR where we have just done a laser, and I wanted to show our fellows that there are some elevated NVEs, so we should avoid those areas. So as you can see over here, these two green circles are having an elevated NVEs. So I had ordered an OCT to see whether these OCTs would pass till that point to make them understand what are elevated NVEs, but as what we can see, no, it's still not passing over there. This was a very peculiar case. As we can see, this is a case of not a PDR, but a diabetic case which has developed into something which is called a localized detachment. Whether this detachment is an RRD, a TRD, or most importantly, a SCISIS. Whether I would be able to understand by doing an OCT? Let's see. As you can see over here, the first scan is showing there is some thinning, so probably there is an inferiotemporal vein occlusion that is causing that, and that has been confirmed over here. But what I can see over here, there is some elevated NVE over there. But still, I don't know. So whether we can utilize the present scan to do a wider OCT? Yes. What you need is already available with you, a trial frame and a 20 diopter lens. And how it has to be done, as you can see, the trial frame has to be put on and the 20 diopter lens has to be kept. And you just go close to the eye, as you can see over here, and you would start seeing a wider OCT. How does it work? So, it works on a principle of displacement of the nodal point anteriorly. So, as you could see, it was here and now the field of view has increased if you displace it anteriorly. So we started our study, which included 40 eyes, in which we had done a 12 by 12 scan, a radial scan by a standard and a 20 diopter lens, using a DRI Triton SS OCT, and the images were analyzed using an ImageJ software. The exclusion criteria was media opacity, poor image quality, or poor fixation. So this is the first image, as what we can see is a 12 mm scan on the top. The second image, what you can see, is just using a 20 diopter, the same image more clearly on the nasal side. You can see a secondary membrane over here, a primary membrane which is elevated. And as you can see, these red lines are the areas which are usually seen by a 12 mm. So you are actually able to see much wider scans and also clearer scans. This is again, as you can see, this is the point where I would probably initiate nasally. So yes, I have got the point. It increases 1.3 times the normal OCT which you have. The other OCT scan which was passing inferiorly was showing it was plastered, but no. There is a secondary membrane where if I peel, I would be able to peel it completely. Yes, this is very helpful. In this case, as you can see, it is very clearly showing the elevated NVEs at the areas which I would like to show our fellows that please do not hit over there with laser. As you can see very clearly over there. The most important case of this, what we could see was just an elevated something over there is much better seen. And yes, I know that this is a SCISIS rather than anything else. And yes, as you can see, beautiful pictures of this VMT, which right now we are seeing just this area with 12 by 12 and with using the 20 diopter lens, it's so wide and beautiful colors with beautiful image quality. But yes, it comes with some limitations. One is a lens reflection. Another one is the lens edge effect. And most importantly, we have to go away with the poor fundus photograph. But yes, we have done some improvement in this kind of a OCT. So normal 12 by 12 would be approximately of this size. With 20 diopter lens, you extend up to 16 mm. But we give you the largest OCT, which is not been there in the prototype function also, which is a 30 mm by using a 90 diopter lens, which every one of us would have in our clinic, as you can see. Is it really comparable? Yes, the quality is as good as what you over there. this result shows that emetropes versus hypermetropes versus myopes of less than 5 and more than 5, all of them show that using 20 diopter has a wider field of view, widest in the high myopes. In the older OCT, whether does it work? Yes, pretty well. As you can see, a 9 mm scan increases to 12 mm. So if you have an older OCT, that would work well also. Future implications, what you see right now is what we have done. The superior and the deep choriocapillary, the deep retinal OCT octa, which we have done, this is what we have, 9x9, and this 12x12 mm, which is maximum available right now, we are giving you widest OCT 20x20 mm. So the take home message would be that we can double or quadruple the field of view. Any OCT can be utilized. Widest field is 20x20 mm, and it works even in the undilated one. So the conclusion is, it's effective, easy and economical. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Vinaya. That's very, very interesting. I have a question regarding octa. When you go up to 20x20 mm, did you get any useful information that you could not get on a without using the wider field? And my second question was, how about the resolution? Because my major problem with Triton swept source OCTAs, I'm very unhappy. It has so many projection artifacts and
motion. So can I have the slides back? So the first question I would answer in the way that octa, because this was not the part of the presentation, this is because our data is on 20 lens, which we have used, and octa is not in the part of the study which I would present. But yes, because we have already gone to doing an octa, I wanted to show that it works even in the octa also. I'm sorry. So as you can see, there are artifacts, and there are more